In this video, you will learn how to deploy eFlow on an Azure virtual machine that is running Windows 10. eFlow stands for Edge for Linux on Windows. eFlow allows to run containerized Linux workloads alongside Windows applications in Windows IoT deployments. We assume that you already have created a Windows VM inside your Azure subscription. To be able to support nested virtualization, in this video we select a standard DS4 V3 virtual machine running Windows 10 Pro 20H2. First thing we will do is installing Hyper-V on the Windows virtual machine through the following PowerShell command. After installing Hyper-V, we need to reboot our Windows VM. Now we have Hyper-V enabled, we will use PowerShell to install eFlow on Windows and to deploy the Linux virtual machine. To do so, we will set the execution policy of the local Windows machine to all signed to make sure that only scripts signed by a trusted publisher can be run. Prior to installing eFlow on Windows, we register the new IoT Edge device in an IoT hub. This allows us to manage the Edge device and have bi-directional communication between the Edge device and the cloud. After registering, we have the symmetric key as authentication type. Note that this makes sense for this simple demo, but when you are rolling out many devices, you will most likely use another authentication mechanism. At this moment, we are ready to deploy eFlow onto our Windows VM. First, we download a Windows installable MSI file that will be used to install IoT Edge for Linux on Windows inside our virtual machine. After that, we use a single command to deploy eFlow inside a virtual machine on our Windows host VM. In this video, we use default options for disk size, CPU count, and memory of the Linux virtual machine, but you can modify those values. You can even assign a GPU to enable GPU-accelerated workloads if your hardware has a GPU available. When the device was provisioned successfully, we can now connect to the Linux VM and verify the status of the IoT Edge runtime. Again, connecting to the Linux VM is very easy by making use of PowerShell. We can check the running IoT Edge modules, the IoT Edge service logs, and we can verify configuration and connection status of the device. Note that some of these verifications give warnings because we are not deploying eFlow to a production-ready environment for this video. Finally, we can take a look in IoT Hub to see the status of our just deployed IoT Edge device. Since we have not deployed any additional modules to our Edge device, the status code 417 is expected. This concludes this video on installing and deploying eFlow on Windows. The next video in this series will show how we can deploy some IoT Edge modules to our newly created device. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.